Good morning. Today we are going to discuss an important topic of the data structure tree. In this, we are going to discuss about these are the following contents that we are going to cover. About the basic terminology about the trees, then binary tree, complete binary tree, then full binary tree, tree representation. So these are the basic contents that we are going to study. There is just for the understanding that how the tree is working, how the tree is represented in the data system. So let's start with the basic functioning of the tree. As we all know, as we have seen that there are the two different kinds of the data structures. One is the linear data structure and another is the non-linear data structure. For the linear data structure, we know that when we are storing the data in a continuous form memory location, and if we are at one particular element, then we are able to access all the elements by going in one particular direction. Either in the forward or in the backward direction, we can access all the elements. So we have seen the example of the linear data structures as arrays, display, queues, linked list. So now, if you talk about the non-linear data structures, so non-linear data structures are those which are not stored in the continuous memory location, in which the data are scattered somewhere within the memory location and they are linked with each other with their proper pointers. So if we are at one particular element, one particular location, then we are able to access only few of the elements by moving in one direction. We cannot access all the elements. So the examples of the non-linear data structures are the tree and the graph. So in that, we are going to discuss about the tree. So in the tree, the basic terminology is there. Here it is a representation of a tree. Here is a representation. The tree is represented like this, in which A is known as the root of a tree. Here, every tree is having the root. So if you look at the real example, then we have this opposite like the tree that we see over there in the real life. It is just the opposite of this. We take the reverse over here. We take the root at the top. Then we are having all the nodes available over here. Here, every element that are seen over here is known as the node of a tree. So A is known as the root node of the root, from where we are able to access the complete tree. Means if you are like in the linked list, we know that if we are having the access of the start pointer, then we are able to access the complete linked list. In the same way, if we are having the access of the root of a tree, then we are able to access our traverse within the complete tree. Now here, when A is known as a root, then A is having the two child. They are known as the B and C. So B is a left child of A, C is a right child of A. If the A does not have any child, then A is simply a single node within the tree. And if the tree is empty, then our root will be equal to none. So if you want to show that our tree is empty, we will just say the root is equal to none. Otherwise, the root will point to the A. A is the root node. Then A is in the left child. B is in the right child. C. Now in this case, the node is having the two child, but it is not always necessary. A particular node can have one child, a node can have two child, and a node can have more than one child. Here we are talking about just the tree. We are not saying it is a binary tree. In the tree, a node can have more than one or more than one child or the zero child also. And in the case C, you can see that the node C is having the three child, A, G and H. B is having the two child, B and E, but the H is having only one child, I. And the node D, E, F and G does not have any child. So, as I told you that a node can have zero child, one or more than one child there. B is known as the left successor. It is a left child of A, so B is the left successor of A. C is a right successor. Successor means the next, which is generated from the parent. So B is the left, C is the right successor. So every node can have 0, 1 or the 2. successor, or we can say the child node. B, E, F, G and I does not have any successor. So if a node does not have any successor, then they are known as the terminal node or the leaf node. So these are the leaf node. There does not have any child or any successor over there. A is known as the parent of B and C. B is known as the parent of B and E. Or we can say that B is an ancestor of B and E. A is an ancestor of B and C. Right? So, like successor or the descendant. In the same way, we can say that ancestor or descendant. So, B and E are descendant of the B. B and E, C are descendant of A. F, G and H are the descendant of the C. Now here we are say B and C, both are known as a sibling. We can define the sibling like this, that if the two nodes are on the same level and they are having a common parent, then they are known as the sibling. So B and C are the sibling because they are at the same level and A is a common parent of both B and C. In the same way, we can say B and E are sibling and A, G, H are also the sibling. But, so F, G and H is having a common parent, C over here. But here we can say that B, E, F, G and H, they are on the same level, but they are not sibling to each other. We cannot say that E and F are sibling. Although E and F are on the same level, but they are not sibling to each other because the E is having a different parent and F is having a different parent. So when the parents are different, then they are not called as sibling. B and E are the children of the B, as we discussed. These are the leaf nodes. Now if there is a direct path from the node N1 to N2, if there is a direct path from node N1 to N2, then N1 is known as the ancestor of N2. And N2 is known as the descendant of N1. So, here we see A and B. So, there is a path from A to B. So, B is the descendant and A is the ancestor. Again, the same tree over here. Now, in this tree, you can see the A, B, C, and H. They are known as the internal node. Internal node means that they are having a leaf node with them. So, A is having the child, B is having the child. So, B, C, and A, and H, which are within the tree, in between, and which are having further nodes forward, they are having the further descendant over there. So they are set as internal nodes. So A, B, C and H are the internal nodes. And we are saying B, E, F, G and I, they are the external nodes. External nodes are those which are at the leaf level. There does not have any further child over there. So they are known as the external nodes. Now here we are calculating the level of a tree. Level is that from the root node level is 0. Root is always at the 0th level, then its child is on the next level higher. The further child or the grandchild are one more higher level and so on. So at every generation of the child, the level get increased. So root is at the level 0, then B, R, C are there at the level 1, D, E, F, G, H are at the level 2 and I is at the level 3. So levels keep on increasing. So by the level, we can calculate the depth of a tree or the depth of a node. Here we can see that the depth of a E is 2 because if you start from the root, then it is at the 0, then 1, then the 2. So E is at the level 2. So depth of the tree or the level of a E is 2. The height of a tree is 3. This is the 1, 2 and the 3. The height of a tree is 3. So as the depth keep on increasing, the height keep on increasing. So height and depth are the two terms over there by which we can calculate the length of a tree. Now here, how many number of nodes are there a particular parent is having? That is called a degree of a node. So here the degree of A, because A is having the two child B and C, so degree of A is 2. C is having the three child A, G and H, so C is having the degree 3. H is having the only one child, so H is having the degree 1. And A, G, B and E does not have any child, as they are the leaf nodes, so they are in the degree 0. If any node is having the degree 0, so it is called the leaf node. Now, there are the two other kind of degrees, that is called the in degree and the out degree. In degree is that how many number of input edges are there for that particular node. So, for the node A, there is no incoming edges there. So, for the node A, the in degree is 0. But for the A, there are the two edges are going outside to the B and C. So, our degree of A is 2. For the node B, the in degree is 1 because one node is coming, one edge is coming from A to B, and the our degree of B is 2, as the two edges are going outside from the B. So, in this way, we can define the in and out degree of a node. So, these are some basic terminologies that we are using in the tree definition. Now, here some examples of the tree. Here is the example in which the tree hierarchy is presented. It is the representation of the electronic structure, electronic equipments. So, we can represent those in the form of a tree. This is another example of the tree representation. Like we are having the HTML codes over there. So, in the HTML codes, at the top we write the HTML. Within the HTML, there are two parts are there, head and the body. And within the body, we are having the further parts over there, further subparts over there. So, everything can be represented in the form of a tree. In the same way, we can represent our family hierarchy in the form of a tree representation. Here, it is another example. If you look at the any diagram system or any file system of any operating system, so we can find that they are represented in the form of a tree. Like here, it is the one form of the directory we have taken for the Windows file system, that we are having the course folder over here. Within the course folder, we are having the two other subfolders, CS016 and CS252. Within the CS016, again we are in the further subfolders, so they are again represented in the form of the hierarchy. So, we can represent so many things in the form of the tree representation. Here, now we talk about the binary tree. As the name is saying, binary tree means that every node will have at the most two child. It can have 0, 1 or the 2, but not more than the 2. So, binary tree is known as the order tree, in which the children of each nodes are arranged in the order. So, in this, every node is having at the most two child over here. Here you can see the example that like the 8 is having the two child, 5 and 4, 5 is having the two child, 9 and 7, 7 is having the two child, and 12 is having the one child. But the 2 does not have any further child over there. Then here, the another recursive definition of the binary tree. A binary tree can either be a leaf. If you have a single node, then it is called the leaf node or the root node, single node will be there. But if it is having more than one node over there, so they are called, it will become the internal node, the root is the internal node, 3 is the internal nodes, and 2, 4 and the 5, they are known as the leaf node. So, a binary tree will have the another leaf, all of the internal nodes, the root, and one or two binary tree, that is known as the left subtree and the right subtree. These are some example of a binary tree. We can represent any arithmetic expression in the form of a binary tree representation. Here you can see the example, the way that it is calculated, that A plus B, so here it is. Then C and D minus, then both are form the multiplication, then E and F form the division, and here division and then the addition. So we can represent this arithmetic expression in the form of the tree representation. Here it is another example of the banyan tree. We can form the distant tree over there. Like if you want to come to the some conclusion based on certain instances. So we can form the distant tree based on that. Like here we have taken the example of the television, that if the television is turned on, no, then if the cable is properly plugged in or not, if no, then there is a problem with the power cable. So we can come to the particular decision based on the set of decisions that we form at the particular level of a tree. Now there are some different kind of the banyan trees are there. One is known as the complete banyan tree. The complete banyan tree can be defined like this, that complete banyan tree at every level except possibly the last one is completely filled. Here you can see the example that in the complete banyan tree all the levels are complete except the last one. But it is not necessary that the last one will remain incomplete. Last one can be the full over there. But all the level except the last one will remain the full. And all the nodes appear as left as possible. Means in this case, if we start numbering the node, then we will start 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and 12. So if you start numbering over there, then it will not find any gap in between. But in place of this, suppose if you design a tree like this. In this case, if you start numbering, then 1, 2, 3, 4. Then here we will not find any further node. So we will form the gap over here. So here it is a gap. Then we will say 6 and the 7. So here we are getting the gap in between. So in this case, it is not called a complete banyan tree. It is not an example of a complete banyan tree because some gap is there. So the condition is here that all the nodes should appear as left as possible. So this is one example of a complete banyan tree. Here if you take this one, if you take this tree, then again it is not a complete banyan tree. As the condition is there that all the levels should be complete except the last one. But in this case, at the level 1, it is not complete because it is having only one child. So it is not a complete banyan tree. But if we add one node over here, then now it becomes a complete banyan tree. Now, next another variation of the banyan tree is a full banyan tree. In the full banyan tree, it is defined like this, that in the full banyan tree in which every node is either a leaf node or possess exactly the two child nodes. Means in which every node should have a two child or it will be a leaf node. Like here you can see the example, every node is having a two child and either the other leaf node or the two child nodes. So it is an example of the full banyan tree. It is again the example of a full banyan tree. Every node is having the leaf node or exactly the two child nodes. Then another variation is the strictly complete or the full banyan tree. Here you can see the example. Here the tree is defined as the letter depth is defined over here, depth 0. Root is always at the level 0 or the depth 0. Then level keep on increasing. Then height of the tree is 3 in this case. Now we can say that if level I is tempted to rest for I nodes. So if you talk about the level 0, so then to rest for 0 means 1 node. So at the root node we are having only single node in there. If we say at the level 1, so to rest for 1 means 2 nodes. So at the level 1 or the depth 1 we are having 2 nodes. So as the level keep on increasing, the number of nodes keep on increasing. So we can define that at the level I we are having the to rest for I nodes over there. If the tree is having the height h, then we can say that all the leaves will be available at the level edge. So in this case, the height of a tree is 3. So all the leaf nodes will be available at the level 3. Here you can see all the leaf nodes are available at the level 3. The number of leaves will be 2 raised to power h. In this case, the height of a tree is 3. So number of leaf nodes is 2 raised to power 3. That is 8. So here you can see, we are having the 8 number of nodes over here as a leaf nodes. The number of internal nodes, number of internal nodes will be, except that this leaf node, all the nodes are the internal nodes. So here it is 1, 2, then 4 and so on. So we can calculate 1 plus 2 plus 2 raised to power 2, here it is 4, then keep on increasing up to 2 raised to power h minus 1. Here we have said that number of leaves are available is 2 raised to power h. So number of internal nodes will be available up to maximum 2 raised to power h minus 1. So if we calculate this series, so we will say here that number of internal nodes will be 2 raised to power h minus 1. So in this case, here h is equal to 3. So it will be 2 raised to power 3 minus 1. That is 7. So in this case, we are having the 7 number of nodes as an internal nodes. 2 raised to power h minus 1. So 7 nodes are there. We can also say that number of internal nodes equals to the number of leaves minus 1. Here the number of leaves are 8 minus 1, that is equals to 7. So number of internal nodes are 7. You can define here. We can also say that total number of nodes will be 2 raised to power h plus 1 minus 1 equals to n. So total number of nodes will be, where the h is the height of a tree, so 2 raised to power 3 plus 1 minus 1. So it is the total number of nodes, that is 2 raised to power 4 minus 1, 2 raised to power 4 is 16 minus 1 equals to 15. So in this tree, we are having the total number of nodes are 15. So this is the total number of nodes. So all these things we can derive if we know the height of a tree and if we know the total number of nodes within the tree. If we say that tree is in the n number of nodes, then we can say that the number of leaves will be n plus 1 by 2. Like in this case, in this example, we are having the total number of nodes is 15. So the number of leaves will be 15 plus 1 divided by 2, that is equals to 8. So the total number of leaves are 8 over here. So number of leaves are this. Height will be equals to log 2 of number of leaves. So we can say height will be equals to log of 2 of 8, that is equals to 3. So we can refer the height by this, by the given number of nodes. Or we can also say that height will be equals to log 2 of n, n is the total number of nodes, plus 1. So we can take the example that if suppose we are given the 10 lakhs number of nodes, then the height will be equals to 21. So we can derive this thing by the given formula over here. So if you know the height of a tree or if you know the number of nodes, so we can calculate all these things very easy. Then the minimum height of a banyan tree. If a banyan tree of height h is at most 2 raised to power I nodes at level I, as we seen in the previous slide, that at every level we are having 2 raised to power I nodes over there. So it will have maximum 2 raised to power h plus 1 minus 1 number of nodes within the tree. So a tree with the n number of nodes, then n will be equals to 2 raised to power h plus 1 minus 1. The number of nodes will be like this, and hence h will be equals to this. So height will be equals to log 2 of n plus 1 by 2. This is the minimum number of height of a banyan tree. Now what is the maximum height of a tree? Maximum height of a tree is applicable when we are having either the left skewed tree or the right skewed tree. This is the example of the right skewed tree. Right skewed tree is in which we are having all the leaf nodes are available only at the right side. It does not have any left side. All the leaf nodes are available, all the nodes are available at the right side. So it is the right hemisphere tree. In the same way, we can define a left hemisphere tree. So all nodes are available only at the left side. So if this is the case, in that case, we are having the maximum height of a tree. As the number of nodes are here, otherwise, if we can arrange this number of nodes, total number of nodes are here 5. So we can form the height tree with the minimum height will be like this. Here, all these 5 nodes are arranged. So this is the minimum height and this is the maximum height over here. Or in this case, it is the maximum height over here. So binary tree with the n number of nodes has the height of at most n minus 1. So if you have the 5 nodes over here, so in this case, the height of the tree will be 4. Like here, the depth 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So here height of a tree is 4. So if you have n number of nodes, so height will be the n minus 1. Then the number of leaves in the binary tree. So number of leaves will be equals to the, it is more than the one more than the number of internal nodes. So as we have seen in the previous example, that the number of nodes plus 1 equals to the number of leaves. So by the induction, we can show the number of nodes, internal nodes. A tree with the one nodes is a leaf, but no internal nodes. If it is a root only, so there is a single leaf or the single node. So no internal nodes will be there. Now this statement is true with almost k minus 1 internal nodes. So if the tree with the k internal nodes has the k 1 internal nodes in the left subtree and k minus 1. K is the root, k 1 is the left, then the number of internal nodes at the right hand side will be k minus k 1 minus 1. So it will be the number of nodes at the right hand side. So the number of leaves will be less or equals to k plus 1 plus k minus k1 equals to k plus 1. Leaves in the binary tree, while binary tree with the n number of nodes, so the number of leaves plus number of internal nodes equals to n. The number of leaves will be less or equals to the number of internal nodes plus 1. Hence, the number of leaves will be less or equals to n plus 1 by 2, or the minimum number of leaves is 1. Here you can see the node structure, how the tree is arranged. Every node that is within the tree is having the 4 parts over here. One is the key value, there is the data that we are storing within that node, the left pointer, a pointer to the left child, a right pointer, a pointer to the right child, and a pointer to the parent. So these 4 things are there: parent, left child, right child, and the data part. Now we represent the rooted tree. The rooted tree is like this: the parent, the left child, and the right child. It is a root node, which is pointing to the first topmost node. Then it is having the left child, it is having the right child. So every node is having the left pointer, right pointer, and every node is different like this. So we can arrange a complete tree like this: the left pointer, right pointer, and the node value. Now it is a unbounded branching of the arbitrary. In the unbounded branching, it is the node is defined like this. Then here we are having a data part, means it is pointing to the parent part, it is pointing to the its left child, and it is pointing to a right sibling. We are having 3 things: parent, which is pointing to the parent node, the left child, which is pointing to the left child, and the right sibling. The right part, which is pointing only to the sibling. If it does not have a sibling, then it will be null. So here you can see, it is the first node or the root node. If the root node does not have any parent, so it will be null. The root node does not have any sibling, only single node will be as a root node. So in this case, sibling will be the null. Now it is having the left child. Like in the previous example, we have seen that every node is able to child left and the right. If right is not there, then the right is null. But in this case example, this kind of a tree, the right part is pointing to the sibling. So if the sibling is not there, it is null. So in this case, the left part is pointing to the left child. Now the child will point to the parent. So here we are able to point up from the parent to the child and from child to the parent. Two will over there. It does not have the sibling, so sibling is null. Now we come to this node, it is the left child of this. Now this child is having a sibling, so in this case it is pointing to the parent, it is having the left child, so it is pointing to the left child, it is having a sibling, so it is pointing to the sibling. Now this sibling is, this is the sibling, so again this is the parent of this, so it is pointing to the parent. It again has a sibling, so it is pointing to the sibling, and as this is the sibling, so it is pointing to the same parent. So these three nodes are the sibling, or we can say that these three nodes are the child of this parent node. So if we are at the parent node, so we can access all the childs by traversing in this way. Then we have to traverse only at the one child, and we can access all the nodes, all the child nodes of this parent. Now this node does not have any sibling further, so in this case it is pointing as a null. Now for this node, this node is having the fourth child over here, so we require only pointer for the one child, and by that we are able to access all the child. So this is another way we can represent a parent tree that is known as the arbitrary tree or the unbounded branch. Now how we represent the parent tree in the memory? So binary tree is represented in the two ways. One is with help of the linked list, and another is by the arrays. So sequential representation is done with the help of the arrays, and the other is the linked list representation. Let's look at each one of these. It is a sequential representation. In this case, we are taking the help of the arrays to represent the linked list, represent the tree in the memory. So it is represented like this, that if you have the n number of nodes in the binary tree, then the size of the array will be the plus for d plus 1 minus 1, where d is the depth of a tree. So like the example that we have seen previous, that if the depth is 3 of a tree, then we can say that the number of the size of the array will be the plus power 3 plus 1, that is 16, minus 1, that is the 15. So size of the array will be the 15 to represent a tree with the height of a tree, 3. Now here, how will identify the integer element within the array? Then which is a parent, which is a left child, which is a right child. So that is identified by, if you want to identify that any node is parent or not. So we will say I is a parent. If it is at I by 2. If I is not equal to 1, if the I is 1, means I itself is a root and has no parent. Here we look at the example. Here we look at the example. Here J is here. J is available at 0th location in the A. So if we say here, or if we represent the same thing with the code like this, if we represent the same thing like this, 1, 2, 3 and so on, if we start here from the 1, so we will say that it is a 1. So we will say that if the node is available at a location 1, so it is the root node, it does not have a parent. For all other case, it will be, if we say I by 2, then we are able to get the node, like H. H is available by this, which is start from the 1 and 2. So this 2 by 2 means it is having, it is the parent, it is having the child. So we can identify the parent at I by 2. So any node, the parent will be at the location I by 2. Like for example, for the D. The D is available at location 4. So if you have to identify the parent of D, so it will be the 4 by 2. That is 2. So H is available at location 2. That is 1, 2. Like in this case, if you have to get the parent of a C, So C is available at the location 4. So you can identify the location of the parent by 4 by 2. That is 2. That is B. If you have to get the parent of a B, so that is B is available in location 2. Now we can say 2 by 2, that is 1. So A is a parent of B. Now if you have to identify the parent of A, so A is available at location 1. So if the element is available at location 1, so it does not have any parent. So it is itself is a root node. Now if you have to get the left side of any node, so left side is available at a location 2i. If the 2i is lesser or equal to n, n is the total number of nodes. But if the 2i is greater than n, then we can say that it does not have any left side. Let's look at the example. Like for the C, C is available at a location 4. If you want to get the left side, so left side will be available at a location 2i means 8. So 8, on the 8 we are in the D, so D is the left side of a C. If you want to get the left side of a D, so that is 2 into I, I is 8, 2, 8, 16, so at the 16 we are in the E. So E is the left side. Same, you can see over here, for the H, H is available at a location 2. So we can say 2i, that is 4, so D is available at a location 4. So D is the left side over here. In the same way, if you want to get the right side of any node, so right side is available at a location 2i plus 1. If the 2i plus 1 is less or equal to n. But if it is greater than n, so we will say that it does not have any right side. For example, if we say for the C is available at a location 4. If we say right side, so it will be 2i, that is 2, 4, 8 plus 1, 9. So at the 9, we does not have any element over here, so C does not have any right side. In this example, we can see H, H is available at a location 2. If you want to get the right child, so that is 2 into 2, 4 plus 1. So it is 5. So G is available at a location 5. So G is the right child of the G. H. So if you want to get the right child of a G, so now the G is available at a location 5. If you look at the right child, so that will be 5 into 2, 10 plus 1, 11. But it does not have any node at the location 11. So G does not have any right side. So this is the array representation. Now we talk about the linked list representation. In the case of the linked list representation of a tree, the tree is represented like this. We define a structure. Like we have seen that every node is consists of the three part, that is the left pointer to the left child, data part and the pointer to the right child. So we have to represent these three things over here. So for this, we define our structure. The structure node. The node is having again three parts. One is the left pointer of the same structure type, the data part and the right pointer. So this node is represented like this, the data part and the left child and the right child. Here you can see the example of this. Like here, we have defined the tree A. A is in the two child, B and C and so on. So the same thing is represented like a tree in this way. The node representation is like this. Then A is at the root, the data part. A is having the left child, so pointed to the left node. B pointed to the right node. C. Now the B is having a child B and E. So B is having the child D and E. B is having the child F and G. So like this. So this way we represent the tree like a linked list in a memory. Now if you have to design a tree with the minimum height, so how we can do? For that, the rule is like this, that if in the tree we want to construct a tree with the n number of nodes, then for this, take the one node as a root node. Out of those n number of values, n number of nodes, take the one node as a root node. Like if you say n equals to 1, if I have a single node, so it will work as a root node. If n is 2, so out of this 2, take the one node as a root. Now what are the remaining is there? The remaining is the n divided by 2. N is the total number of nodes divided by 2. So n is 2 divided by 2, that is 1. So one node will be work as a left subtree. So this is added as a left subtree. Now in this case, n is let's say 6. So in this case, out of six, take the one node as a root. We are left with the five. Now out of six, we will say, if you have to filter the left subtree, so that is any six divided by two, that is three. So three number of nodes will be as a left subtree. Now, if you have to filter the right subtree, so right subtree will be take the number of nodes, any set of the number of nodes minus the number of nodes in the left subtree, that is 3 minus 1. This 1 is for the root node. So we are left with the 2. So those 2 elements will come in the right subtree. So same process keep on repeating in the recursive form. Let's look at the example. Like in this, we are having 21 number of nodes and we have to construct a tree with a minimum height. So we will take the first node, let's say, as a root node. So we have taken the 8 over here as a root node. Now we have to construct a number of nodes in the left subtree. So number of nodes in the left subtree will be the n divided by 2. N is 21 divided by 2. So we will get the 10. So out of this 10 number of nodes from here up to here. From 9 up to the 1, these are the total 10 nodes over here. These 10 nodes will be come at the right hand side. Sorry, left side. Now the remaining 10 number of nodes will come at the right side. Now apply the same process in the recursive form. Now we start for the same from 9 to 1. Now take the 9 as a root node. So 9 is at a root node. Now here the total number of nodes are 10. So out of 10, take the one node as a root node. Now the number of nodes in the left subtree, so 10 divided by 2, 5. So 5 nodes will be at a left. The number of nodes in the right subtree, that is the total number of nodes minus the number of nodes at the left minus 1. So we are left with the 4. So 4 number of nodes at the right subtree. So out of this, take the 11 at a left and so on. So every time we apply the process in the recursive way and keep on reducing, and that tree will construct with the minimum number of heights. So that's all for today.